Okay, so we've updated our results, and obviously we have a really large number because we searched for job satisfaction as a very broad topic. And not only that, we did not search for job satisfaction as a phrase. Phrase searching is probably my number one go-to search technique. It's the quickest way to narrow down a particular search based on that term. Phrase searching uses quotation marks to find words in the exact order you type them in with no other words in between. In other words, this particular search that we've done for job satisfaction is searching for job anywhere and satisfaction anywhere. So not necessarily together. A lot of our results, we do see them together. However, as those results decrease in relevancy, we might see job on page 1 and satisfaction on page 20 of that article, meaning they're not relevant to our topic. So what we want to do is put quotation marks around our term, so we will be searching for it as an exact phrase. And watch the results, the number of results here, to see how dramatically they decrease when we apply this phrase searching. Phrase searching, by the way, works in most all library databases and also within Google and Google Scholar. So even if you're searching for a business or an event or a web page that you wanted to find in Google, you can always use quotation marks. So now we decreased it pretty significantly since we applied that phrase searching. Still, 77,000 results is way too large. If job satisfaction was our topic, this would be an unrealistic number of results to sort through. So we want to start using other techniques to narrow that down. So the next thing we want to think about doing is using the Boolean operators. Boolean operators combine keywords in searches. So many of the library's databases, you'll see the Boolean operators on a drop-down list like you see here. And, or, and not are the Boolean operators. So depending on which one you've selected, it will either broaden or narrow your search. So let's go ahead and put in some additional keywords and combine them with these Boolean operators. By the way, if you go into a database and you don't see the Boolean operators, it's probably because you are on a basic search screen. So you can always look for an advanced search option, which we are now in order to see the multiple boxes with the Boolean operators. So let's say our topic was indeed job satisfaction, but we want to know how employee engagement relates to job satisfaction. So we could combine our terms with the and, which is the default here, and we're going to choose employee engagement. So let's go ahead and update our search. This should reduce our results again significantly since we are getting more narrow with our topic. So now we're down to just under 4,000 search results versus 77,000, which is what I believe we had before. Another operator that could be used is the not operator. I don't typically use the not operator, but there are some circumstances where you may want to use the not operator. In this case, let's say we are seeing results for a specific industry that we are not interested in. So in this case, I'm interested in job satisfaction and employee engagement, but I'm not interested in it as it relates to the healthcare industry. Maybe I'm only looking at other industries. So I can go ahead and put not healthcare in my search. So this will eliminate any article that mentions the word healthcare anywhere in the article. So just keep in mind that when using the not operator, it is possible that you will eliminate potential search results that are very relevant to your search. But let's go ahead and try this. Okay, so now we have limited our search to just 2,600 results when we eliminated those healthcare articles. So that is an example of how to use that not operator. I'm going to take out this last line so we can do an example of using the or operator. Let's say we're interested in job satisfaction and either employee engagement, or we've noticed in the literature we see the phrase work engagement. So if we type in or work engagement, I'm first showing you what not to do. Okay, I actually do not recommend using the or operator from the drop-down menu, and I'll show you why. So we're going to press search, and then I'll explain why this is going to give you irrelevant results. So we're up to over 12,000 search results. And basically what this particular search is doing is we're looking for job satisfaction and employee engagement together in the same article, or we're just looking for the term work engagement. So work engagement is no longer associated with job satisfaction. Those articles can talk about work engagement in any sort of context, which is why our results went up so much, and which is why you'll see results without any mention of job satisfaction. So sometimes students will use this or operator and not know why they're getting such irrelevant results. Other times, it can lead to millions of search results and you're not quite sure why. So instead of using the or operator here, I'm going to show you how you could effectively use that. And that is by using a nested search. Nested searches we talk about more in searching 102, but because I'm showing you what not to do here, I want to show you how to fix that. So a nested search will search for any of the phrases or keywords within your nested parentheses. So here, I am looking for job satisfaction and either employee engagement or work engagement, but it still must have job satisfaction. So using this technique will make this go down from the 12,000 results to something that may be a little bit more manageable, especially once we start adding our additional limiters or terms. So you see how dramatically that went down as well.